didn't get much tastier than this. Fiji, Canada, Argentina and Samoa.
A couple of real brutal pulls out here in Hong Kong. Means you've got to be on your mettle every game. Certainly difficult for the likes of Canada and Kenya, as we just witnessed, to be in what are brutal pulls. But whenever there's a challenge like this, you really want to galvanise your team and so you can stand up for Canada.
Brenning Prevot, delighted to have him back in the red of Canada, kicking off into the arms of Mbuka Yaro, sets it up for Fiji. Fiji just taking it to the line and challenging the Canadian shoulders. Hint of maybe would there be an opportunity, but instead Fiji danced through.
High tackle.
Well, penalty for a high tackle there. And Fiji, well, they've had three podiums so far this series, but no gold. You have to go back to 2010-11, the last time Fiji didn't get a gold medal on a series. They'll fancy it here in their home from home, Hong Kong, and they're putting it through the hands. They're zipping it out wide. They're galloping with purpose, and they're in, and they're scoring. And it's Talatolo to open up proceedings for the Flying Fiji. And oh, by a whisker.
Well, just taking his time within goal to enjoy every moment, rightly so. Hallowed turf here for any Fijian, but what about the ball from Mbatarenga? That is beautiful. Right in front of the giant striding Talatolo. You're never going to see him without a smile on his face as he is running around to score a try. But the pre-build-up play there was spectacular.
The easiest of conversions to maximise the try from Talatolo, back having missed the last four series events. And back making a difference.
It's a welcome return. So I'm striding out in Dubai for his opener. A giant of a man, but just a wonderful presence on the field.
Well, he's brought back with some of the purpose of competing at the kickoffs, and it is good competition. But Canada getting the ball back. They struggled in the first half against Argentina yesterday, but there goes the man from Calgary, Matt Awuru, home of the Stampede. And he does a bit of stampeding himself before Canada go flinging out. That's beautiful. Not even out the back door, maybe out of the skylight there a little bit. And Mora throws the miss and juggled a little bit, then not regathered.
Knock on.
And Canada cough up the possession.
Well, that's unfortunate because that was beautiful from Burnett. Love the skylight. That's exactly what it was. Over the top, round the back. That's what you want to see on a centre field. Slightly looking for Warren there. It looked like it bounced forward rather than went forward. But either way, we're now setting up for a scrum.
Don't go early. Nice and square, please. Crouch! Nice and square.
Fijian strike weapons ready and waiting.
Sit!
Locked and loaded. Fijians at the ready, but losing their footing. Keep the ball alive, and back they go to the left. The side of the field they profited. Ooh.
No advantage, hooker leaving
they get
early.
A penalty. Here they go. Plenty of tempo being driven in, rushing at the red jerseys. Big defensive read coming out, the tackle doesn't come in. Canada left scrambling and they're left chasing the shadows of the Fijians. Uwani Temba, as he did here in November, scoring freely. Fiji with their second.
The Fiji Blue, always a presence here in Hong Kong. What footwork, bounces on the outside of Russell, the Thunku, and then the ball out wide. And yet again, another smile a mile wide. Another try for Fiji. Seven tournaments they've taken down at the last 10 here in Hong Kong. This place is some home for them.
Well, Temba himself, he scored 26 points in one match alone here in November. And he's off to to a pretty sweet start here against the Canadians. The Fijian fans always so colourful. Oh, an awkward fall. And still he hasn't got back up, so we are going to halt play.
Contact in the air.
It's going to be checked, and it's going to be a penalty to Fiji.
Contact in the air.
Yeah, the optics on this look so bad.
19.
Because Talathola jumps so incredibly high.
Time off.
He goes over the top of the Canadian pod. Berner's looking completely the way, so it's unintentional. Russell's trying to get lifted. That's commitment, but it's
19,
so dangerous.
Four. Landed dangerously.
And mercifully, looks like Talatholo's okay.
What are we going?
So Berner's copped a yellow.
Scrum. Scrum.
Understandably, because of the optics of it. But his back was to him. In that situation, it's really for Russell to try and tell his lifter it's off and just go solo. We're lucky there that Talatholo is walking away from it. That looked pretty bad.
Time on. Crouch!
So Fiji
bind.
Leading by two scores.
Sit!
And with a numerical advantage to see out the remainder of this half. And they go. Off they set. Mthungu. Oh, so good. Mthungu ghosting through that Canadian defence. Not a fingerprint on him. Oh, so easy for one of the arch try scorers of the series.
Had to really concentrate hard to not finish off that so good with another couple more since we are in Hong Kong and it's anthemic. But it's just the effortlessness, Nate. The way he just glides on the outside. In that one movement, he's done three attacking things that most people just can't do. The step, the movement, the goose step, the change of pace. Mthungu is just a pleasure to watch when he's playing sevens.
Just the 132 series tries for the man, and goodness knows how many try assists has he got to his name as well across his career. Conversion sailing over into the south stand, and the same man will kick us off. That's some rap sheet for Fiji's number 8. Again, Fiji winning that scrabble on the floor, having competed hard in the air. Mthungu's off. He's not happy with one. Oh, so instinctive from the Fijians, but still the ball alive. And out to the flank. Some hitch kicking, some stepping, some injection of pace. Then the backdoor boogie. Classic Fiji just operating in broken field. And Temba's in for a double.
Well, I'm glad he is, because there was an absolute clear and obvious pullback from Kratz in the middle of the field to stop an earlier try from Fiji. Mthungu again carving through. The white of the shirts matched by the white of the teeth. Right in front of the south stand, soaking it up here in Sokompo.
Extra couple popped on to the total. Hong Kong's come and Fiji have delivered in this first half, leading 26 versus Samoa up next, and that's being followed by USA v Japan. Much work to do for Canada, and if you thought the kickoff routines were good from Fiji before, they just brought on Longoni Massi, who did win the lead, but Canada retained the ball. Penalty there though. Fiji are on their way again. They seem to have scored every touch they've had, and there's numbers lurking on this left side, galloping through Bati Rarenga. Well picked up by the Canadians. Here's a chance. They search through the hole. Caught by a handful of shorts. First time they've been attacking in the Fijian half all game. A tricky ball well picked up by Mora. And off they go down that left wing. Max Stewart flipping it out the door to Mora. But oh, The assistance flag up, denied a wonderful North American score.
Oh, what a shame. Everything about that was scintillating. The offloads, the belief, the confidence for a team that are getting hammered at the moment. So close to the sideline, you can see, oh, it's inches that's off. Let it go, I reckon. That was flowing.
Go that way, go that way.
Well, more fresh legs coming on for Fiji. Soliano volley. Making his way, just his second World Series appearance. He actually made his debut back in 2020. That's a big old long wait to make your second World Series event.
You don't have to mention that too much in Hong Kong. They've been waiting for this. The fully charged Hong Kong Sevens. Canadians still supporting their team. But Fiji looking effortless with ball in hand at the moment.
Well, they need to be their eighth man at the moment to inspire them to come back against this supercharged Fijian side, who are looking really good, really threatening from anywhere on the pitch. There's the big man, Longoni Massi. Good tackle and breakdown work from the Canadians. They win the penalty. They're in a hurry.
Holding on.
Lockie Kratz gets us off and away. Sells the dummy and almost bought by the Fijian defence. Red jerseys pouring through, bit of deception. Will Persillier on debut gets a try at the famous Hong Kong Sevens.
Lovely moment for him, and that is how you do it. You want to take on Fiji, be more Fiji. Takes the tap, backs himself, scans. The short option is the one on, dummies it brilliantly. And then it's the speculator over the top. Fijian defenders looking, searching, but not finding Persillier. What a moment. First try, let it fly.
Extras added. And plenty of fight in this Canadian team. Will Persillier, named for the future, the number 77. But no. That is a killer, isn't it? You get your score and then you make the kickoff error.
Yeah, we only had to see in that first half how effective Fiji are. Backing up the scores.
He has to play it.
You've got a bit of confidence in the tanks for Canada.
He has to actually play it.
And then it's emptied by the restart.
And
just to get scale of that mullet when he turns around at his name. Not quite similar scenes in the sideline, but enjoy themselves nonetheless.
So what are we saying? Him and the squid go to the same barbers?
I reckon you're not far off wanting one of those, mate.
Bye!
It is. Quite glorious.
Sit!
From Thomas Isherwood. Velawa picks up and gets on his bike and Fiji bursting through the tackles, looking for offloads. They didn't make their way across the 10. It's hungry defense from the Canadians, almost tipped up but put down safely in the end. Longoni Massi. Oh, finding an inside ball, then the instinctive offload. The Fijians in the mood as they come into the 22. Hands to the right, inviting the quick finish, the hop, the skip. Oh, the shape-shifting feet. The flying Fijians taken off at the Hong Kong Sevens.
The first real showing in this second half of what we saw in the first. Devastating right footstep, sliding straight through it. Mike Samoa's done it all year and is continuing. In the home of Sevens.
Nice conversion to boot. The points continue to be piled on Mike Samoa. Some scoreline for Fiji with only a slither over 2 minutes remaining, and well, it's all happening for them. They find the only patch of green grass there and out for the line out.
What a kick. Front line
Fiji
was taken.
Line.
You know they've got
Fiji
the aerial threat, but to put the ball right in the corner And Batirenga with the skills.
Elias Hancock climbing highest, and then the fumble from offside. The try scorer, Max Stewart,
he's finally came
is off and away. Another debutant. Just on the doorstep of the halfway line. Isherwood bounces back to the short side. Bit of variety to the Canadian attack. Oh, that's a nice bit of ball manipulation. And Isherwood charging on, almost coming up with the miracle offload, but not quite with the shoulder mobility to make it work.
Wow, that was an effort, wasn't it? We've seen some brilliant offloads from Canada in this game. Just to check they weren't wearing white. Oh, lucky. Was it the hair? Could it have been? No, it couldn't.
Had to go through the curtain.
It was drawn. Isherwood, he's put out some worlders this year. That'd have been right up there.
It's been a bit of time playing rugby in from your neck of the woods, from Morley RFC and Leeds.
Should get away with that in Morley.
Here come Fiji in the final 30 seconds. Game wrapped up. But by how many? But by how flashy? Nandunvalo finishes the job for Fiji with one final try.
Oh, no smile this time as he canters round. Nandunvalo just loitering. My Samoa is such a threat. He draws two defenders in. Of course he does. And then that is track style sprinting. And it seems right and fitting that it finishes with another Fiji score.
Another successful kick, and Fiji bag 40 against Canada, full time 47 to Fiji. Wow, an impressive display by Fiji. We saw some great invention there from Canada, who are still chasing their first win, and they have the daunting proposition of Samoa ahead next. But I think we're going to get to hear from Dallin, who's